you can see on your screen. And they will be going up against this lineup of SKT. Nice bit of burst damage out of Faker. See if he can line that up. Some damage from Wolf as well. But here we do go. We're going to have Meowkai up in the top lane. Excited to see that as well. But let's jump into game number two right now. SKT versus BBQ. Welcome to game two of match 29. As Binu did mention, match 30 will mark actually the 1/3 mark of LCK Spring. Already a third of the way through. It's been fun so far.
Has been fun so far indeed. And this match, game number two here, so far no fun has occurred, unlike game number one. Ghost going to be fortunate to keep his flash this time around.
For now. Looks like he's okay in bot lane, but they are totally spotted coming on in here, and BBQ's all kind of mixed up. And so far, BBQ getting the better of the trade, but they know they've been spotted, so they don't want to take any chances. We'll just back off. Really trying to disrupt this sapling play at the Raptors we've been seeing more and more often.
And Totoro and Ghost just trying to zone Bangin' Wolf out. That way they can get a little bit of an edge early on. And I really like the leash that Peanut is getting here so early on from Faker. And a little bit of his assistance from Huni. It really helps conceal what routes he can go for, as he's not going to be tunneled into the standard routes of red, wolves, into blue.
Nice ward, though, placed here. They will spot the red and see Peanut going towards his blue side jungle. And wow, Totoro getting really aggressive here. The exhaust coming out, and thankfully, the missed Peacemaker there will save Totoro's life, but a bit of a mistake, and he's forced to use both summoners as well as Ghost Seal to get away.
Yeah, he's used both of his summoners right there, and already the bottom lane off to a terrible start yet again. You can see Bang already has a CS lead. Bless now making his way down, and this is what they need to do. Now Peanut not really in position to handle this yet, and this could get really ugly.
Oh, here we go, the jump onto Bang, and the root is not going to go through, but it doesn't matter. First blood going over to Ziggs, and a very nice quick gank out of Bless.
Peanut a little too slow there on his root, not able to be in bottom lane, and they weren't respecting the gank from Bless there, and they paid for it. And meanwhile, up in top lane, actually, Crazy putting down a lot of pressure, and he's going to be extremely safe. And taking a look at this replay, this is the most standard as they come. Peanut not able to get down there. And the damage from Bless at that stage just did too much. But hold that thought as coming back into real time.
Yeah, no flashes for anyone in bot lane. And Peanut says, what did you do to my bot? Let me come on over and get a double kill. And that he does. Nicely done by him to follow up there, as there were no summoners for the bot lane.
Meanwhile, up in top, Huni's actually under quite a bit of pressure. Doesn't really have the mana to stay in lane. And now with Bless making his way up, he's going to have to be really careful here. If his recall gets canceled,
that was
close. Been really bad, yep. But Bless is going to be able to take away the Golem camp away from Peanut. And while this won't hurt his root too much, because the Wraith camp is about to come back up,
well,
still does pressure him nonetheless.
Yeah. And look at this. Crazy is going to teleport in behind Huni and try to make something work here with Bless. Huni does have his flash, and they don't really know where Peanut is. So, well, they're actually going to try here once again, but now Peanut is spotted. Bless is actually going to jump on into him, the miss Sonic Wave, and all of a sudden Peanut has to get out of here. Hooney in a bit of trouble, still has his flash, trying to turn out to Bless, he gets the kill, and might get away with his life here. Peanut threatening Crazy, is still getting a bit of damage onto him. Crazy still thinking about what he can do as Talia attempts to make a rotation up top, but no can do as another kill going over to SKT.
And that was really peculiar because it seemed like Peanut didn't want to take the fight against Bless, but then when Hooney arrived and he still had flash available to him, it was easily picked up. And the red buff now going over onto Hooney, and Talia not being level 6, not able to roam up to top, didn't have the Weaver's Wall available. But meanwhile, I mean, Tempt is keeping up again with Faker in the mid lane, at least in terms of CS.
Yeah, at least doing that, but let's take a look again at this fight.
So the replay is really interesting. You can see that Bless couldn't really make up his mind. He leaped onto Peanut right there, but the amount of damage coming out from Peanut was just too much for him to really handle. And when Hooney came over, it was a really standard kill.
Yeah, especially with double Durant that early on, he does a surprising amount of damage at this low level. So always have to be careful, take everything into account. Seems like Bless was unable to do that time around. And getting a closer look at the mid lane, you can see that Faker's slightly ahead. No big movements have been made. There was that one time Talia did rotate. Here comes Peanut down into bot, but he is spotted by a ward.
Spotted by a ward indeed, but doesn't really matter too much. They do spot out Bless, and that is very valuable. He's not even able to finish his entire Golem camp, as the threat of Peanut is too much.
Yeah, and Peanut easily able to walk in there because both teams know how low Bless is, and they can't really, Ghost and Totoro can't make that move. We're gonna see another trade here in the river of top lane, but more interestingly, here comes Peanut, the exhaust comes down, he's gonna take a ton of damage, will get both of the kills as Temp does come in for the follow-up. Zyra ends up picking that kill up, in fact, and no assist even for Temp, so yeah. Definitely a good trade for SKT.
Totoro getting that kill there and not, well, Temp not getting the kill and instead Totoro getting it is basically the worst thing that could have just happened for BBQ. And where the gold just went for BBQ is not where they had ideally wanted it to go. And Peanut able to pick up the kills there. But also, the big problem is that Ghost ends up missing the wave, and he misses all the experience that comes with it. This is going to guarantee that Bang and Wolf are surely going to hit the level 6 spike way before the opposing bottom lane. And with Bless not going to be able to give any aid down to bottom, I don't know what they're going to do in coming minutes.
Yeah, you were talking about how that's really going to be the focus, how they want to get ahead down in bot. We're going to take another look at how Peanut came over using that Blasting Plant.
Use the Blasting Plant, got into range, and then using the Dragon's Kick there, able to just dish out so much damage with the help from Bang. And right before Tempt was able to arrive via the Weaver's Wall, just died to the turret.
Well, hold that thought. There's more damage, more action, I should say, in bot lane about to be damaged. Here comes Faker and Peanut. Nice flash out of Totoro. Looks like it won't even matter. Peanut finishing his work, does get the kill, and he will get another double kill as he picks up Ghost. And the nightmare of the bot lane for BBQ tonight continues.
Nightmare indeed. And meanwhile, Bless on the left-hand side of the map, trying to get the red buff, and Hooney came down to check that out a little bit, but so far in game number 2 here, it's basically the same song and a dance as game number 1, where Ghost and Totoro are just causing too many problems for the mid, top, and jungle of BBQ to be able to handle.
Yeah, I mean, Bless is trying his best. He got a nice kill early on for them, picking up Bang in the bot lane, and it's just not really working for them after that, as they did not have any summoners after getting very far behind at level 1, in fact, due to a mistake from Totoro. So they're really going to have to go back to the drawing board in that bot lane, I feel, and just study from this game at what they're doing wrong and how they can improve, because that's really all you can take away when you face one of the best teams in the world is, you know, how hard you got crushed, how can that help you?
little bit of a trade happening here in mid between Faker and Tempt, and basically just softens him up to make sure that Tempt's not going to be able to rotate up to top or remain in mid lane too long.
Well,
hold that.
Yeah, exhaust comes down. One more hit will do it, and the flash away from Faker. Bless still on the chase, but Beanut will come in support. And a nice solo kill there from Faker. Nobody on either team able to come in time to help out with that one.
Huge solo kill right there at this point in the game, as this is not a situation that you want to be in, as BBQ Ghost still tied up in bottom lane. SK Telecom already initiated the rotation up to top lane. They chose to put it in top because Caitlyn doesn't offer a lot from the middle, but because Faker and Tempt are still able to have that type of a clash that we just saw unfold, and you don't really want to interfere with that at this stage of the game. Additionally, because Tempt had the blue buff and the wave player on Taliyah, it wouldn't serve much of a purpose for Bang and Wolf to go mid.
Yeah. So really the only thing that was working for BBQ in this game was the top lane, but you could see that all that Huni had to do, as we have a pause here, is just not die. He gets behind 20 CS, but it just doesn't matter. As long as he doesn't feed that Renekton, allow him to get super far ahead, he can take the hit in CS as long as he's not handing over kills and potentially that top turret.
And hopefully we find out the reason for this pause in a moment.
Yeah, not sure what is happening here. It looks like it's a pause by BBQ's top laner, Crazy. Sound problems. So that is the update for you guys.
Right now, Crazy's actually under a little bit of a siege from Bang and Wolf up in top. And as a Renekton, I don't think that you want to be getting sieged by Caitlyn and Misfortune. BBQ about to pick up the bottom tier 1 turret, but that doesn't really matter that much as they're already so far behind in tempo.
So, reading the Korean lips, he says it's all good now. So we're going to be getting into this in just a sec. Looks like everything's okay. Nice little smirk. And yeah, lots of pressure on this guy to make something happen with his lead. You could see how hard Faker was already hitting with that Jace with just the Dirk and the tier as his items. Now finishing up the Yomus. And here comes Tempt. He's going to spot Peanut. So knows that that top siege gets even scarier with him around.
Peanut basically just there to add presence and pressure to the Taliyah, in case she would potentially get the idea to try to help out Crazy. Now they are looking to respond with a Rift Herald capture, but Crazy's sniffing that out, able to dissuade them from it.
Look at the amount of damage from the one Q of Jace. Knocks down Kha'Zix to half health. And then the extra damage coming out of Misfortune gets him even below half health.
Bang and Peanut looking to set something up onto Ghost. We'll see if he falls victim to this. He doesn't really have that much of a reason to keep pushing on beyond this cannon wave. Looks like he does read it.
Yeah, he does read it, but is it in time? That's the question. Faker's coming in. Nice block there with the plants, and in fact, the ultimate of Zyra too, to save his life essentially and do a nice chunk of damage to Huni in the process.
Huge rotational play shut down by BBQ. Very well timing by Totoro there with his plants.
Oh.
And despite the damage going down, Peanut still able to complete the channel of his recall. And look at that damage.
We just gained like 200 more Jace players in solo queue from that one queue. And yeah, I mean, that's the amount of damage you can do with just the one item at this point with Jace. 12 minutes into the game. And Tempt, well, he was just pushed out of the lane with that one Q. Goodbye, Tempt. You're going to have to go back to base. No answer to Faker here in mid, as he may just take that mid turret by himself. Peanut hanging around for presence. Will clean up all of the vision. This is looking a lot like game number one, down to the damage that was done early on. Crazy getting out of position. He was their only hope. Can he get away? Nice slow from Bless to help out, and in fact, he will.
manages to get away right there, and Ghost actually casting his ultimate despite SK Telecom having backed off. It's not the best usage of that, but in the meanwhile, they were at least able to hold mid. Faker wasn't able to complete that, and now Tempt up in top lane trying to hold off Bang and Wolf. Surprised a little bit that they haven't rotated Bang and Wolf to mid lane just to finish the capture of that tier 1 turret. Seems like they're taking things pretty slow and steady, and fortunately for BBQ, the next dragon spawning is actually a Cloud Drake, which isn't of the most use for SKT right now.
Yeah, not really going to help them out much at all. I suppose you get slightly faster rotations, but that's about it. Slightly better engages, but definitely would have liked a Mountain Drake or an Infernal Drake. Look at the damage coming out from Wolf alone. One Jace Q could triple kill at this point as Peanut is coming on in. Deciding not to go for it, would probably have gone for it had the Jace Q landed. Shock Blast, and everybody is just forced back from the amount of poke of just Faker here, and Wolf, I suppose, earlier on.
And Peanut actually in a side lane, pushing, actually even gonna begin to start hitting the turret.
And by himself.
Faker just dishing out so much damage right now. BBQ basically has no response to this. Peanut managed to raise top tier 2 turret. And SK Telecom 15 minutes in again, almost at the 7k gold lead yet again.
Peanut, I think, even has the same score line, something like 5-1 and 2. Faker, if he lands those Qs, they could even end this earlier. Here comes Peanut is not going to land the combo on Tempt, and that may have been a little bit overzealous if he had gone for that too. Oh man. Goodbye, Totoro. Now it's your turn to go back to the base. And here they go for the dragon. You know, same issue as game number one, where they're like, oh, this is a bad dragon, let's just kill it as soon as possible. We want a new one.
We'll have to see what the third dragon of the game spawn shall be. Infernal.
Yeah. Last time it was Mountain. But last time it was also Double Ocean, so you guys can see the pattern that's forming.
And off of the recall, Peanut now getting a little bit more tanky stats. Already has the Hex Drinker, but Taliyah, having been as gimped as she has been this game, not really putting out too much damage. And honestly, this committed rotation up to top lane could almost be ignored by SK Telecom, but then, I mean, if you look at the remaining objectives for them to capture, there's almost no incentive to ignore it, given that they can't capture anything else. Baron not even on the map yet. Rift Herald could be something that SK Telecom should be interested in. But Huni down in bottom lane might just be content to get some turret damage down.
Looks like it. Ace in the hole gonna come out, do a bit of damage, and just dissuade BBQ from pushing any further. As Maokai backs off, Huni just going to take a break from pushing. And maybe now they can make a move towards that Rift Herald. It looks like Peanut wants more blood.
Just getting some vision control and presence inside the left-hand side jungle. And it does look like they are going to get that Rift Herald right now. And I think it would be a pretty poor choice if BBQ does try to contest this.
Well, they're TPing in, but here comes Maokai too. Rift Herald does go down. Trying to be given to Peanut there. He does pick it up. And Huni's in the back, and he's going 1v4. But here comes SKT trying to join on in. Is Huni going to go down? It doesn't look like it. Peanut jumping in, able to take out Taliyah early on in that fight. And this is just going to be a rout as everybody as BBQ is on the run. Oh, not going to land there. Bless gets away with his life for now.
Bless able to get away right there. Some close calls in that fight for SKT. Wolf almost went down there, but Bless able to escape last minute. Will Bing actually check? Okay.
Very close.
Yep, no Peacemaker. And now the game resetting a little bit again. SK Telecom, curious to see if they will play as slow and methodical as game number one, but you can see this team fight where both teams call in for a teleport, but a little bit questionable by BBQ as they don't really have the resources to take this fight, and especially not from this angle, but Ghost able to land such a gigantic ultimate for his team right there, chunking down multiple members of SKT, and then Totoro able to snare up Faker there, ended up saving Bless's life.
It was kind of comical to see four members of BBQ trying to take out Maokai at this point in the game. They're just so under farms that nobody has any damage. So it's not even like Vinny's all that farmed. This is going to be another kill going over to BBQ as a nice play there by Crazy to open that one up.
Nice play indeed, taking Faker down. Edge of Night, though, completed for him now. Not able to get any objectives off the kill, but at least it gives them a temporary breather.
Yeah, four now, and it seems like BBQ's holding on a little bit better out of some of these kills that they've been able to scrounge up throughout the game. Not getting as rolled as the last game, even though the gold lead is still pretty far ahead.
You can see the gold difference there between some of the champions. Most notably in mid lane, Faker ahead by about 1,700 gold, and then AD carry position as well, 1,700.
Jungle was about 2K. Peanut picking up 6 kills in a 20-minute game, making that Lee Sin look good. And the Baron has spawned now, as we are after 20 minutes. So the last time we saw SKT to slowly take all the vision and then go for that Baron.
Probably going to be the same story as game number one, using the Baron to open up the base of BBQ. Jace doesn't quite have the poke to be able to do it single-handedly on his own, at least not against the wave clear of Taliyah. And with the Dragon coming up as well in just under a minute, can almost be sure that SKT is content to wait for it and then capture that, as it's basically free right now.
Ward spots Bless, and uh-oh, he's on a bit of the run here. Peanut is going to spot him with his E, and down he does go. And that might just be the key to opening up that Baron. Nice ward placement there to spot him out, too.
And if that wasn't the key, then that Shock Blast probably certainly was, as SK Telecom have started the Baron. Crazy doesn't have teleport available to him, neither does Huni, and yet they do back off.
There was a lot of vision around. It looks like they really want to secure the Drake first, perhaps, as the mid-second turret is down. So maybe they just want to clear out a bunch of the vision and then make a move towards one of these two objectives.
Peanut now moving down to the Infernal Drake. He's going to be able to thank Ghost for a little bit of a leash.
Yep, thanks for that. Good job, Ziggs, helping out. And so that does go down, and uh-oh, Totoro. Oh man, that's so close. He gets hit by one of those Shock Blasts. He loses probably more than half of his health at this point. Bless. They're trying to make something work on Tabang. He's kind of caught out all alone. Look at the map. There's nobody else here for SKT. He's going to try to make the miracle escape, but down he will go, very unfortunately. Maybe trying to pad his damage stats just a little bit there towards the end, make them pay for it, but just a bit out of position is Bang.
Bang getting caught out of position. Another kill picked up for BBQ. They're going to need a lot more than that, though, to bounce their way back into this game, especially when Crazy is basically glowing glass cannon on that Renekton. Doesn't quite have a defensive item yet. And SK Telecom, with the way that they're moving around the map, it does look like they are going to just be ultra slow and methodical with how they're going to choose to close out this game.
Peanut trying to make the flashy plays, trying to catch Ghost out of position. He might get jumped on here by Crazy. Peanut is very content to turn around, especially with that Rift Herald buff. Here comes Wolf to help on too. It seems like they do want to pressure this red. Going to kick him on in. He's really thinking about it. Temp is getting very low, but the red buff will go over to Bless. And Peanut just doing a nice bit of damage to some of the members of BBQ.
Red buff going over to Bless. Meanwhile, in mid lane, Bang able to escort that wave into turret before being handed off by Faker. And now SK Telecom setting their focus on the bottom half of the map and this bottom tier 2 turret. BBQ has to concede this. There's almost no chance that they can win a team fight at this point in time. And they're doing everything that they can to try to stay inside of this match. But as long as Faker can land a Shock Blast onto any member, they can crack this base wide open and take a team fight.
Yeah, nice bit of damage coming out there from the combo of Ziggs and Zyra, but able to flash away is Wolf. And you can see just the amount of burst damage that SKT has to knock down some of these turrets. Even with the wave clear of BBQ, they can do it. Next Drake is Ocean, which, you know, is pretty much a throwaway one at this point. But they're looking to make a push before it, and look at that. Tons of damage coming down onto Ghost. Hooney just strolling through the base, doesn't really care about that. Wall does come down, he's gotta be careful, he's now down to half health. Oh, oh man, Faker is just 1v3ing this team right now. Crazy coming on in, trying to get that kill. Bless is able to take him out. Hooney in the front taking a bunch of damage now, has to back off, flashes the wall. And that's not quite the fight that SKT wanted.
Not the fight SKT wanted indeed. Faker getting absolutely gutted right as that broke out, and Peanut not in a position to really offer aid. And that was just a problem of SK Telecom being a little bit too split up, and Faker basically making a mistake choosing on who he wanted to go on, as BBQ was able to jump in, jump out, and get him. So the Weaver's Wall being used to zone off Bang, and then you can see that Peanut doesn't commit to hitting his Q, and once Faker hit his Shock Blast, he went in, but it was met by Crazy locking him up, and Bless able to come over the wall, get the kill onto Faker, and then Hooney forced to flash away, while meanwhile at the north, Bang, Wolf, and Peanut were basically tied up and zoned out.
Yeah, so even though they do make that mistake, they're still very far ahead, about 9,000 gold. But yeah, he landed that Shock Blast, and Crazy is really the only guy on this team that's holding it together for BBQ, I'd have to say, at this point. Some pretty nice plays, nice setups to get kills onto Faker. Multiple times, actually. Second time that's happened.
Next dragon of the game coming up in about a minute and a half is another Water Drake. Not going to be the highest priority for SK Telecom, but definitely a breath of fresh air for BBQ.
Maybe now, wow, okay. Talia still does a nice bit of damage, even though she's not all that farmed up. And maybe they want to begin to push towards that Baron. They were clearing out all of the vision around it. So far, BBQ doesn't have much. Had that Shock Blast landed, Bless would probably be below about half health. Oh man, Wolf taking a lot of damage here too. They have to be careful with how they engage. Look at Wolf's health now. He can't even get close. And here comes Crazy coming from the right side. Thankfully, he's still at Exhaustor. That might be the kill onto Wolf. And this is going to force SKT back once again.
SK Telecom getting forced back once more, and the damage that's coming out from Tempt and Ghost is just a little bit too much, and if SK Telecom misstep at any point, it's very easy for BBQ to potentially just burst them. And this is a little bit worrying given the fact that SK Telecom has a 10,000 gold lead and they can't find a way to close it out, and with no Baron opportunities presenting themselves, they're gonna have to wait for another dragon to come up. Not just the Water Drake, but a question that SK Telecom can ask themselves is, do we wait to capture this dragon to guarantee that an Elder spawns next?
looks like that's the play for now. They're ignoring it entirely, and this is the SKT that can't really seem to find a way to close things out. Usually they're very dominant. They have a plan with what they're doing, but they kind of seem lost. I mean, again, they're still very far ahead, but they're not able to close this one out here. And Crazy down in bot lane, making a bit of trouble on that Renekton. Makes a bit of sense. Maybe that's a pick that he's played a lot in the past, and now he's like, okay, well, let's just give it a try here going into game two, especially with the way that game one went. Maybe we can change it up. Maybe they're not too used to facing this Renekton. And we saw that Huni did have a lot of trouble with it in lane, and seems to be very good on it so far.
Lots of pings going down onto Baron now. Completely neglecting the Ocean Drake. That's a little bit surprising, and just leaving Faker to completely gut anyone that comes into vision.
Good vision play by Totoro to use that one plant to get vision. See if they're doing it. It looks like Peanut has actually started it. And the back ward, they're behind the team. They're not going for the start. Going to get onto Ghost. Oh, man. Actually, the Q of Maokai makes the Sonic Wave miss of Peanut, so they cannot get the kill onto Ghost. Now, Bang getting very low. They're going to try to pick it up onto Totoro, and finally, they find a kill somewhere on this map, and that should be able to open up this Baron, or at least more control around it.
Well, it's definitely going to open up a lot of the control around it, but they have to be careful. Ghost still has his ultimate available to him, and if they are grouped up, it can be pretty disastrous for SKT. Wolf now zoned out. There's the ultimate that I was talking about, being able to flash out, though.
Nice play by Wolf behind the wall, doing a ton of damage. Tempt will go down. Crazy, the only one that's really been in the front line for this team, will also be melted. And now Ghost and Bless on the run. Down he goes, another Sonic Blast. And Faker on the chase here will be able to get Bless. A double kill going over to Faker. And they should be easily able to take the Baron at this point.
Yeah, this is going to be a free Baron for SKT. Recall off of this, although with Faker already in mid lane, he's going to be able to tap those minions with the Baron buff. And you can see Totoro down in bottom knows that he can't do much else. So what he's trying to do is attack the next obvious rotation so that they don't have any minions available to tap off of this. Faker going to get the inhibitor now. It looks like SK Telecom don't have any intentions to recall, at least not yet, as they tap the top wave as well.
Wish we got to see more Faker Jace. He's making it look pretty strong right now. Sonic Blaster just chunking everyone on this team. So many squishies.
So you can see in this replay that despite Ghost's ultimate, Bang was able to flash to safety and then tempt, going over that wall there, but still able to be locked down by Bang and Wolf. And right at the end there, I mean, it just became the great chase where Faker was able to dog down Bless in the end.
Taking another look at the gold, I mean, it tells the story of that everybody on SKT is extremely far ahead of everybody on BBQ at this point. SKT was just able to go back, and essentially everybody got a new buy. Bang's hitting on four items now. And we're getting to that point where it looks like SKT might be able to end this game here. Doesn't look like there's much hope for BBQ in this one. They're going to need a bunch of mistakes from SKT, I'd have to say. Some kind of botched fight where somebody gets caught once again and they can't push with four. I mean, the wave clear out of BBQ is still very strong, but they're going up against a team that is so far ahead. Look at that chunk onto Totoro. It's unbelievable the amount of damage. Now the wall is going to come down, but still no doing.
This doesn't even matter really at this point. SK Telecom, too much damage available to them. Now with the second inhibitor of this game falling, don't know what BBQ is left to do. Yes, they have wave clear, but it's not really that great against the Baron empowered minions.
Yeah, Ghost can barely even get close to even hit those Baron-empowered minions, so then you're just adding even more to the push. Two inhibitors down, and they look to push the top lane. Want to take this one slow. Oh, man. That's their mid lane there, and now Ace in the Hole even chunking down Bless.
Faker staying inside of the base, and that's exactly why. As his teammates escort the wave up.
Oh, Peanut jumping on in. He's going to get the kill. And oh, man, he almost lives there, too. Wolf wants a little bit of love as well, getting the kill onto Talia. This is just the route as everybody has to run away. That's going to be the end of game number two as SKT coming back off their loss just absolutely destroy BBQ in a quick 2-0.
Yep, quick 2-0 indeed. Struggling a little bit in the mid game there to find a way into BBQ's base. And BBQ suffers yet another loss to a top tier team. Basically, they're going to really have to find themselves moving forward into the remainder of this season because their only wins have come versus the lower tier teams. And a lot of the problems that they're seeming to have is inside of that bottom lane of Ghost and Totoro. Meanwhile, on SK Telecom, as I mentioned, wasn't really too concerned with their loss to Afrika, at least not in the manner in which it occurred. And tonight, again, they came out super strong, as always.
Crazy, he didn't look too happy there towards the end. He had a very nice early game. He was really the only one performing for BBQ. Bless had a decent early game. But as you said, lots of problems to be addressed for this team if they want to try to do a bit better towards the second half of LCK Spring 2017. We're going to take a quick look at a replay here.
This is just the end game push where Faker was positioning himself for constant shockwaves. Peanut able to find his way in right at the end there, went down for it, but didn't matter as the bullet time able to dish out so much damage. And from this point, it was just basically Bang raising the Nexus turrets before ultimately SK Telecom destroying the Nexus of BBQ to finish out their series.
That's what Jace looks like when you face an all-squishy team and he's massively far ahead. Can just chunk you for about 80% of your health. You just have to have some good dodging skills. Maybe a Cloud Drake to help you out. Huni, he had a rough time early on, but as I said, the fact that he didn't die was very important. Didn't get Renekton farther ahead. Getting another close look at the disappointed faces of BBQ, especially that bottom lane.
Can't help but feel bad. A lot of the problems from this series did come from that bottom lane. So no surprise that they feel the way that they do.
Yeah, so guys, we will be jumping to the final analyst desk segment of the first matchup here. So let's find out who our MVPs are in just a